BBC Audio presents The Country Girls, a BBC Radio 4 full-cast dramatisation of the landmark trilogy by Edna O'Brien, starring Charlie Murphy and Aoibhinn McGinnity. The Country Girls by Edna O'Brien, first broadcast on BBC Radio 4 in 2019, dramatised by Lynn Collin and directed by Sally Evans and Jessica Dromgoole.
Am I talking to myself?
What? What are you saying?
Good God Almighty, I'm hoarse from saying it. Do you want a white or a brown egg for your breakfast?
Ask me nicely and call me Doty.
Doty, Ducky, darling, honey bunch. Do you want a white or a brown egg for your breakfast?
A brown one, Hickey.
I have a gorgeous little pullet's egg for you. Don't be long.
Hickey's our workman, and Mama's never managed to train him not to bang the doors. He's nice to me, and I love him. I even say to the Virgin Mary, I love Hickey. She never says anything back to me, except once, and what she said was very private. It was when I got out of bed to say an aspiration. I'm always saying them. I'm afraid of hell. Here. Did you sleep, Mama?
No. You had a sweet in your mouth and I was afraid you'd choke if you swallowed it whole.
Poor Mama. She was a great worrier.
Put some butter on your egg to soften it up.
Dada went 3 days ago with £60 in his pocket. We'd never know if he'd come back in an ambulance or hackney car he hadn't paid for.
Can I bring Miss Moriarty some lilac?
Yes, darling. Bring her anything you like.
Oh, you're the best Mama in the world.
There now.
Mama holds me close like she'll never let me go. I'm everything in the world to her.
Old Mammy Palaver. There's a play on tonight at the town hall. You should go, missus.
Maybe I will.
What jobs do you have for me, ma'am?
The turf is ready for footing and we mightn't get a fine day again.
All right, grand.
Maybe he shouldn't go so far away.
Your father mightn't come home for a month. We have to get on. I must feed the hens.
Get the lilac from the back of the hedge.
And take a little piece of cake from the tin for your lunch.
Do you want me to stay home in case he comes back?
Oh, no. Don't be silly. Get off to school. But get your cake and put your coat on first.
It's warm.
You have a bad chest.
Will you come and meet me?
Oh, why must you always be hanging on to me?
Please, Mama.
You're not a baby anymore.
Please.
I'll tidy up after Hickey's dinner and then I'll come down.
Promise me.
Oh, come on now. You better go. You're my best girl.
Mama, you're squeezing me.
Oh, go on now. Off with you.
I'm always afraid I might meet Dada on the road or he might come home and kill Mama.
Ah, Kathleen, my child.
Hello, Mr. Holland.
How are things?
He's trying to sound casual, but I know perfectly well why he's waiting for me under the ivy wall.
Mother, well, your dad is conspicuous by his absence. I see Hickey at the creamery these mornings.
Everyone's grand, thanks.
No. Would you allow me to convey you over the wet, winding road?
It's not wet, and for God's sake, don't talk of rain. It's as fatal as opening an umbrella in the house. Is Mr. Gentleman away?
Indubitably. Odd fish, Kathleen. Odd fish.
Mr. Gentleman is a beautiful man who lives in a white house and plays chess in the evenings. Gentleman isn't his real name. His real name is French, but no one can say it. He doesn't seem to mind, though. He signs all his letters J.W. Gentleman, so he must like it.
Oh, and the voice on him. It's no more than affectation, if you ask me.
He is French.
What kind of an excuse is that? You know what, Kathleen? Many Irish people are royalty and unaware of it. There are kings and queens walking the roads of Ireland, riding bicycles, imbibing tea, totally unaware of their great heredity. Ach, your mother now has the ways and walks of a queen.
Jack Holland doesn't dare come up to the house anymore since Dada ordered him out of the kitchen for putting his hand on Mama's knee.
The wet, winding roads, brown bogs and black water, and my thoughts are on ships and the King of Spain's daughter.
He's thinking up something for his column in the local newspaper. I was walking with a lady exchanging bits of goldsmithing column.
Oh, now, trouble brewing.
I'll carry those flowers for your morphy face. See you at school,
Baba!
Oh, as I was out one morning,
the bean. You've got terrible bad luck, Kathleen.
I know. She'll give those flowers to Miss Moriarty and get all the praise for herself.
Baba, what are you doing putting that lilac in the pot? Those are my flowers.
You're late. You're going to be killed, murdered, slaughtered.
I'm sorry I'm late, Miss Moriarty.
What? What are you talking about?
Baba's gone and made me apologise to Miss Moriarty, and she never even missed me.
Now, we have great news today. Our school is honoured. You, Kathleen Brady, have won a scholarship.
Thank you very much, miss.
We won't do much work today as a celebration.
Where will she be going, miss?
To the same school as you, Barbara. Wouldn't it be nice for you?
Baba writes me a note and throws it at me when Miss Moriarty isn't looking.
So, you're coming to my school then, are you? I've my uniform got already. Of course, we're paying. It's nicer when you pay. You're a right-looking idiot.
All I can think is that I'll be getting a lift in their car, and she'll tell everyone in the convent about my father. Still, I know Mama will be pleased.
Goodbye, Miss Moriarty. Have a lovely afternoon.
Goodbye, Barbara.
Oh, would you look at the state of you? What's you want a coat and a scarf for? It's the month of May. You're like an Eskimo.
What's an Eskimo?
Mind your own business.
What soap are you using? It smells lovely.
You don't even wash in a bathroom. Bowls of water in the scullery and a face cloth that your mother made out of an old rag.
We've got a guest room.
You have. And there's oats in it. The place is like an old barn with chickens and a box in the window. Did you fix the lavatory chain yet?
It's a wonder Baba can talk so fast. Yet she can't manage to write a composition and gets me to do it for her.
Come on if you're coming.
What's the dopey face for?
Mama said she'd come and meet me.
What are you, a great baby? So, what's the news?
We got a candlewick bedspread from America.
My mommy saw Big Ben on her honeymoon.
Would you come in? Come in!
What's he want?
There you are, Kathleen. Your mama is gone on a little journey.
Gone where?
Now, don't get excited. Jack is in charge, so have no fear.
Mama.
Now, now. You'll be all right. You're to stay at Baba's house.
The nerve.
But don't upset yourself. I'll get you something to steady you.
Keep crying and let's see what he gives us.
To your health.
Will Mama be long?
Well, Hickey could tell you that if he's not snoring in the hay shed.
Thanks very much, Mr. Holland.
I'm going to ask you a favour. What about a kiss, girls?
Toodaloo, Mr. Holland! Oh, my toe!
Sure, it's only a trap for the rodents.
Get it off me!
I slipped a bit of bacon in it this morning. There now. All well. So, about that little kiss.
I'm too young.
Touching, most touching. You have a lyrical trend.
Why did you fall over?
I stepped on a mouse trap.
I'm coming home with you. I might get a few rings.
You are not.
Yes, I am. I'm going to get some flowers. My mother sent word over. Didn't have time to ask your mother, could I?
My nose is getting wider. Have you noticed?
Your nose has always been wide. You've a nose like a petrol pump. What do barbers have for their tea?
Bread and tea, I suppose.
Hair soup, you fool. And what do they have for their dinner?
Hair soup?
Jugged hair, you idiot.
God almighty, your house is a shambles. Hello, St. Anthony. Hello, St. Jude, patron saint of hopeless cases. There's packets of butter on the floor.
Mama keeps it on the flag so it stays cool.
Might as well have it towards your keep. Would we go upstairs and have a look at your mama's jewellery?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.